This video will demonstrate how to install Psi4 from binary. I'm going to start out on the psicode.org website and click on manual to go to the user manual. On installation and runtime configuration, I'm going to click on installing from binary. And then on installing from binary, I'm going to select quick installation. And I'm going to follow the notes that are in this section here. So what I have are a sequence of commands to execute inside of a Linux or Mac terminal. And when those complete, I'll have a successfully working version of Psi4. So first thing I'm going to do is execute the command bash. So what I've got here is a SSH terminal open to an Ubuntu Linux desktop that I have. If I look at some things here, if I say the host name, the name of the machine is chemdemo. If I say which shell I'm using, by default I'm using bash. You can see which shell you're using by default by doing that same command, whether that's bash, C shell, or TCSH, or some other shell. And my username in this case is tmpchem, with my home directory being /home/tmpchem. Okay, so the first thing for me to do would be to execute the command bash. That's going to be redundant for me since I'm already running the bash shell, but I'll go ahead and do it anyway. Okay, so now if I echoed shell, it would still be bash. This curl.o repo.continuum.io/miniconda, etc. This is going to download the miniconda package from continuum.o. Miniconda is a package repository from which we're going to download the Psi4 binary. So I'll execute that command. You can see that it'll take a few seconds here. And we're done. Okay, that appears to be successful. So next is we're going to execute this shell script, which we just downloaded in our home directory /miniconda, where it's downloaded to. This will accept the license agreement and download the package. Okay, so that's installing various packages within miniconda. So I can see now, not only do I have this miniconda shell script that I downloaded, I have a miniconda directory inside my home directory where I've installed it at /home/miniconda. Okay, now I'm going to add the path of miniconda/bin to my bashrc file. Take note of whatever shell you are running by default. If you're running TCSH or C shell or some other shell, this command could be slightly different. Note that at this command down there. They'll just end up executing the analogous commands for TC shell or C shell. Okay, so I've piped that path variable into my bashrc file. So if I look inside my bashrc, I see at the end here where that command has appended to my path, my home directory /miniconda/bin. Okay, and then I want to test that miniconda is now in my path. So we could either log back out or log back in, or I could source my bashrc file, or whichever rc file you're using. And now if I say which conda, I have conda installed in miniconda bin conda. Okay, so once conda is in your path, we're going to do conda update --yes --all. So that's going to update conda to whatever the latest version is. Downloading some packages here. Okay, that's complete. No errors. Configure this to add the Psi4 package. So conda config add channels conda.anaconda.org/psi4, so that we're going to have a Psi4 binary within our conda repo. Okay, in this case I already have this because I have another version of Anaconda in another location which I have commented out at the moment. So that should add Psi4 to you. Now we're going to say conda install dash dash yes Psi4. So executing this command, we're going to then download and install Psi4. There are some other packages associated with that which it'll install as well. Okay, so now we're downloading Psi4, progress bar at the bottom. Okay, and now that's finished up. So it's asking, do I accept the Intel end user license agreement for this redistributable? That's just for the linear algebra libraries that are within the package. So I'm going to say yes. So notice here the things that popped out at the bottom. This is the notes for if you use C shell or TC shell instead of bash, the things that you're going to add to your TCSHRC file or whichever RC file your user is going to use, those commands there. Okay, so we have Psi4 that we have downloaded there. Let me see if Psi4 is in my path now. Which Psi4? Psi4 lives inside of my home directory /miniconda/bin/Psi4. All right, now we're going to run this command to test whether our installation of Psi4 is working correctly. So we're going to test this Psi4, see what it does. Running some Psi4 exiting successfully. So we have successfully tested our Psi4, our downloaded version works, and completed successfully. Now the last thing we want to do before we declare victory is to set our Psi-scratch environmental variable. So quantum chemistry can write very, very large files, and those files can be on the order of gigabytes to even terabytes for large computations. And by default, if you don't set this Psi-scratch variable, it's going to default to writing to /temp/tmp. And that's designed for smaller temporary files. It's not designed for gigabytes and gigabytes worth of quantum chemistry files. So that could really cause issues with your system if those files are writing to /temp. So instead, what we want to do is set a Psi-scratch variable, which is usually a larger space on some other disk, where we can write these very large quantum chemistry files. So don't execute this command verbatim. You're going to set this Psi-scratch to the path to whatever scratch that you have for your particular user on your particular system. And then that variable is going to go inside of our RC file. And again, if you have some TCSH or C shell, follow those commands for that variable as well. Okay, so in my case, I have scratch set up inside of a disk where I have this directory /scratch mounted on an external hard drive. So I'm going to look at that directory, and my directory within Scratch is /scratch/tmpchem. I can see that I own that directory. You should be able to have write permissions and read permissions to whatever directory you use for Scratch. So I'm going to add that command now. I already had it in my bash RC, but I had it commented out for this demo, so I'll just add it back for now. So I'm setting Psi-scratch equals /scratch/tmpchem. And now if I source my bash RC file, or you source your C shell or TCSHRC, now if I echo the environmental variable Psi-scratch, it is my scratch directory /scratch/tmpchem. So now we've successfully downloaded and installed the Psi4 binary. We've tested it. It works correctly. We have our Psi-scratch environmental variable set, and we are ready to run Psi4.